going to open our sketchbook to a double page spread. That's two blank pages together. And we're going to draw squares using our black marker. The squares are going to be about 1 inch by 1 inch. And if you have a sketchbook about the size of a notebook, there's going to be 6 squares across and 8 down. And you're going to do this on both pages of your sketchbook on this double page spread. Notice the squares don't have to be perfect. Don't get a ruler, but there is space between each square. Once you have all the squares drawn on both pages, we're going to make our first design. Let's look up at the ceiling. I'll show you how to do it. Do you notice all these pipes and bars on the ceiling? What I want you to do is look at the negative spaces. We're used to looking at positive shapes, like this chair that's filled in black. The negative spaces are the shapes in and around the positive shape. So you see the spaces in the chair that you could actually slip your arm through? Those are negative spaces. Those different shapes that you see in white on this picture of a chair are negative spaces made up by the positive shape, the edges of the positive shape. So if you look up at the ceiling, look at the shapes in between those different pipes, okay? Let's try to draw them. Take a look. So in my sketchbook, using my marker, in one of these tiny squares, one of these 1 inch by 1 inch squares on my sketchbook page, I'm going to look at that shape made up in between the different pipes. It's not, the whole thing's not going to fit in the square. And now I'm drawing the edge of the pipe on the other side. See that? It kind of looks like an upside down triangle. I don't want you to just scribble zigzags quickly in a square. That's not going to work. I really want you to look at the different shapes. This time I'm really focusing on one of those negative spaces. It kind of looked like an upside down triangle. And now I'm drawing the pipe again, but now I'm doing it a different part. So it's a slightly different shape. So remember, I got those two little designs drawn by looking at the negative spaces on the ceiling. Now look at these floors. They have been painted a bajillion times over and over again. There's all different shapes in the floors of different colors of paint and scratches. You see that one shape kind of in the upper middle part of the screen? I'm going to try to draw that shape, that scratch on the floor, in a square in my sketchbook. Can you see it? It's kind of like a weird squiggly shape. I just drew the shape. Now we're going to go out into the hallway and look at all these different paintings on the ramp. These paintings were done by art seminar students over the years here at Brookfield Central. So many beautiful paintings. Let's take a look at this one. You can see the whole painting is of a woman, but I'm not going to draw a woman in one of these squares. I'm going to focus on just one of these paint drips that I see that the student did while she was painting it. She dripped a lot of different paints and inks. I'm just going to focus on that shape. You see it? That's all that I drew. I didn't draw the whole painting, every single shape. I just drew a little bit of a paint drip that I saw. And I'm going to look at a plant. There's some negative spaces within the plant. So that's kind of the areas that don't look green, but look through the plant, and you can see behind it. I'm going to draw one of the shapes that I see. That's a negative space. So the outlines are actually edges of the different plant leaves. But the negative space, the shape you see, is what I could actually like poke a pencil through. Here's another plant. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to look at the shapes that look through, like to the white of the window back there, in between the leaves. And now I'm going to try to draw that shape that I see in one of the squares in my sketchbook. I'm drawing the negative spaces. Believe it or not, these little doodles, these little shapes, are going to turn into beautiful designs. Looking at this jade plant, I'm going to focus on a couple of these leaves on top here, and it almost looks like one leaf is kind of intersecting or overlapping the two leaves that I'm looking at. So I'm actually going to start by drawing around one, two of those round leaves. And then, like I said, another one looks like it's kind of overlapping it. So there's the edge of the third leaf. So let's pause now before we watch the second part of the movie while you go out and do some drawing. Do you remember this panel in the hallway? The painting of the woman? And I looked at just some of the paint drips on there and I drew that shape in a sketchbook square. Well, now I'm going to take my tracing paper and with my pencil, I'm going to trace that shape that I drew in my sketchbook. I'm tracing around the edges. Then I'm going to go to a brand new blank page in my sketchbook and I'm going to flip over the tracing paper and trace on the back. So what's happening are the pencil lines that I traced over the shape with originally are going to be transferred onto my paper. Okay, so when I remove my tracing paper, look, it's transferred. Then I flipped my tracing paper over again, and I want to retrace it. Do I want to do it to the left or to the right of this first shape? I decided to the left. So now I'm going to trace over that again. So you'll notice I'm making a mirror image of what I just traced. Now I'm going to flip my paper over, kind of upside down, and I'm going to trace it again, a third time. Each time I put my tracing paper on there, it looks like a mirror image of the shape I traced before. Now I'm going to flip my tracing paper over again and trace it for the fourth time with my pencil. You'll notice after tracing this four times and making sure that the ends touch or overlap, that I now have one solid shape. The ends of this shape are still open, so I'm going to take my pencil and just close them off. I could do any sort of shape I wanted. And then I'm going to fill in the negative space, those interior shapes that I've created by putting these four shapes together. Anything now that is an enclosed shape is the negative space, and I'm going to fill that in with my pencil. This is my first design. Let's try another one. Remember, that was based off paint drips from a panel in the hallway. So remember that scratch in the floor? Let's try that one. This time, this shape is just a shape by itself. Unlike the first shape that I traced that had some negative space in it already, this one doesn't. So I'm going to just trace this shape. You know what? I'm going to add that little bit on the outside too that kind of broke out of this square. So now I have that scratch from the floor, and I'm going to turn back to that new page in my sketchbook, and I'm going to flip over my tracing paper. And I'm going to trace the shape that I just traced. I'm just tracing over the back. So my original pencil lines are going to be transferred onto my white paper. Perfect. And if I missed a little, I can always take my pencil and trace over it or redraw it. So now you'll see I flipped my tracing paper. And I have the ends of these shapes kind of overlapping a little bit. And I'm retracing. See how they overlapped? I'm going to end up using my eraser and erase it so it's all connected. And then take my tracing paper and flip it upside down the other way. Make sure they overlap a little bit or touch. And then trace over my lines again. And then, I'm going to use my eraser there to make sure it's all connected. And then flip my tracing paper one more time. Remember, every time I flip my tracing paper, I want it to look like a mirror image of the last tracing of that shape that I did. Now, I really wanted you to see this one because there was no negative space in the original shape. But look, I have now created negative space by putting these four shapes together, right? So I'm using my eraser to erase any time where they overlap, any parts where they overlap, and I'm going to then fill in the negative space with my pencil. That's really going to help me see if it's all connected and if I have negative space, because the strong designs are really going to have some good negative space in there. This would be a beautiful pendant. Perfect. Now I'm going to try it again, though, after using my pencil and eraser here to fix this. I'm going to try it again. Let me show you another option. Here's the original tracing from my design walk, right? This time, before I trace it, I'm going to draw around this shape. So now the shape becomes the negative space. See that? Now I'm going to try it again. So I'm going to flip over my tracing paper, and I'm going to trace over the original line and this new line that I just traced. So you see now there is negative space already within this shape. Let's see what this looks like if I do this four times, and then decide which one you actually like better, the first one or the second one that I'm doing. So here I'm going to flip my tracing paper and trace over both shapes here that I've drawn. And you'll notice I did overlap the ends a little bit. So I do use my eraser of the pencil quite a bit to fix these finished designs. Now I'm gonna flip my tracing paper upside down the other way. There we go. Make sure it touches or overlaps, and then trace again. Flip it one last time, get the ends to touch or overlap a little bit, and then trace over the original shape and that new outline that I drew, and trace again. Now I use my eraser to erase any parts that have lines on the inside. And I do often go back over it with my pencil to make sure that I can see those edges really well. And then I filled in the negative space. Which one do you like better? The one originally done, or this new one, where I created a lot more negative space? This counts as two designs finished for my sketchbook assignment. I need to do 10. I personally like the one with more negative space, but it's up to you. Now I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to trace over another shape from my design walk, and this one is just one solid shape, right? There's no negative space on the inside of the shape. So I'm going to go back to that blank page in my sketchbook, and since I really did like that second one I just did, where there's more negative spaces, I'm going to trace around this shape, and then I'm going to flip over my tracing paper. And I'm going to do this four different times, right? So they all connect in my sketchbook, and I'm creating one larger shape that ends up looking like a beautiful, intricate design. So flip the tracing paper. So it's a mirror image. Decide which side I want to put it on. Get those ends to touch a little bit or to overlap. And then I'm going to trace this a second time. Perfect. Now I got to decide where I want to put this when I flip it again, on top or on the bottom. I kind of like it on top because this little stem sticking out of my shape. I like how that touches because I know it's going to end up creating some really cool negative space on the center of all four of these tracings. You see that? So I'm going to flip it for a fourth time, retrace around both of these shapes, these pencil lines, the original shape on the inside and then the new one I drew on the outside, right? So that inside becomes some beautiful negative space. And then I use my eraser to erase anywhere where it overlaps or where there's lines on the inside shapes. And this time, instead of using my pencil, I'm going to take a highlighter and I'm going to fill in the negative space. I like how it looks, and honestly, it goes a little bit faster than the tip of a pencil. But it really highlights that negative space, because I really want you to fill in the negative space so you can see what parts of the design would be cut away, because the actual positive shape would be the metal for your project. Okay, so this highlighter, I'm filling in the negative spaces on the inside of the shape and also all around it. And the thing that's left white would end up being my metal. This is a beautiful design. I really like this. This would be a lovely pendant. Last one here. I'm going to trace over this one. Remember, the original shape was from a jade plant. Now, this time, I'm actually not going to trace around this shape. I know there's no negative space in it. There's not an enclosed shape within this. But I have a feeling if I trace this four times and I overlap each time, see it's overlapped up there on the top? And then I trace it, and I do that two more times on the bottom. I have now created a beautiful negative space shape on the inside. So I'm going to flip my tracing paper, make sure those shapes touch. Do you see that? They're touching or they overlap a little bit. And I'm going to trace it and flip it for a fourth time and trace it again. Now look at that beautiful negative space that was created on the inside. So I got to use my pencil to erase where those lines overlapped, kind of redraw a little bit, and then fill in the negative space. Again, I'm going to use a highlighter for this one to fill in and around the negative space. I need to do 10 designs for my sketchbook assignment. And believe it or not, some of these designs you're going to use for your first two projects and maybe even a project later on in the term. Now, I am going to add one little thing to this design. I want to think about how this would hang if it was a pendant, and I could certainly hang a cord or a chain through that middle shape, but I'm actually going to add two little cutouts here on the ends. They'd be drill holes or cutouts, and I would hang my cord or chain from that.